students, welcome back to Dhanya's classroom. It's me, Dhanya. Today we are going to learn the second chapter of 7th standard social science. The title of our chapter, that is From Trade to Power. What is that? From Trade to Power. Somebody entered in our country for trade purpose. Later they became the rulers of our country. I think you are interested to listen stories. In your textbook, first page itself included beautiful story. Are you ready to listen that? Please listen. What is that? Even the black gold has a story to tell. Friends, I'm Pepper. Can I invite you to the Europe a few centuries ago? The rural folk in Europe would kill some of their cattle for meat and preserve it for the prolonged winter season. Then that means this is a story of Pepper. Pepper told something for us. Then the village people of Europe would kill some of their cattle for meat and preserve it for the prolonged winter season. The heavy snowfall in the winter was not favorable for the grass to grow in the cattle field. You know that winter season means that is the snowfall season. During that time, the lack of grass, that is one of the big problem they faced. Both the people and the cattle faced a shortage of food during the season. The solution for this was to preserve the cattle meat as food for winter. Then remember that there was neither electricity nor refrigerator of any kind during that time. During that time, electricity was not invented. Then how they store that meat? Then so they found me effective in preserving the meat and making it tastier. Me means pepper. In short, I was inevitable for them. My friend cardamom, cinnamon and ginger, all spices like am, were also loved by them. The traders came in search of us from the time immemorial. What did you understand from this story? From this story, we realized that the spices of our land were essential for the foreigners. Then the spices of our country were essential for the foreigners. The traders all over the world used it to visit our country for what purpose? To collect these spices. From our first chapter itself, we realized that the Turks conquered Constantinople. Do you remember that year? In which year Turks conquered Constantinople? No doubt in 1453. What happened? When Turks conquered Constantinople, this dismantled the trade relation between Asia and Europe. The situation necessitated the European traders to find out a sea route to our own country, that means India. With the discovery of sea route to India, the Portuguese, the Dutch, the English and the French reached India for what purpose? For the purpose of trade. Our topic, that is from Portugal to Calicut. What is from Portugal to Calicut? That means somebody from Portugal started their journey to reach our India. Then that person reached our own Calicut. Then are you ready to listen that beautiful story? Then listen. It was a sunny morning in the month of May 1498. What is May 1498? You just imagine that scene. Then it became easy for you. Three huge ships anchored at Kapada near Calicut. What is that? You just watch the three huge ships were anchored. Then the language and dress code of the mariners in the ships were quite different from the native people. They were the group of sailors from Portugal under the leadership of Vasco da Gama. Who was that person? Vasco da Gama. How many ships? Three huge ships. Which year? 1498. During the arrival of Vasco da Gama, the ruler of Calicut was Zamorin. The Zamorin, the ruler of Calicut, did not provide trading facility to Vasco da Gama. Then what happened? So he left for Kannur, gathered necessary goods and then returned to Portugal. Listen, my dears, Vasco da Gama got a profit which was 60 times greater than the cost of their voyage by selling the goods they took back with them. Portuguese were also known as Parangis. What is that? Portuguese were known as Parangis. We realize that Vasco da Gama and their team reach our Kerala. Then they realize how to reach India. After Vasco da Gama, a lot of persons reached over India. Then which are that person? Listen, Almeida and Albuquerque. Who are that? Almeida and Albuquerque. Two sailors from Portugal reached here for trade following Vasco da Gama. Following Vasco da Gama, two sailors are entered in Navo India, in Navo Kerala. Then who are that? Almeida and Albuquerque. Next, which are the major trade centers of the Portuguese? Goa, Daman and Diu were the major trade centers of Portuguese. Goa, Daman and Diu were the major trade centers of Portuguese. They constructed Saint Angelo Fort at Kannur and Kottapuram Fort in Thrissur district. Two forts they constructed. The name of first fort, that is Saint Angelo Fort at Kannur and Kottapuram Fort in Thrissur district. Agricultural crops like pineapple, guava, papaya, red chili, cashew, tobacco, etc. that are found in our Kerala now were introduced by Portuguese. That means these are the agricultural crops very familiar for us. These are the contribution of Portuguese. The widespread use of printing machine and the development of an art form named Chavittu Nadagam were some of the impact of Indo-Portuguese relationship. Important question waiting for you. What is that question? Listen. Portuguese could not establish many trade centers in our country. Why? What may be the reason? First point, Portuguese did not have enough economic and military resources to compete with other European powers. Then after Portuguese, a lot of European countries entered in our India. Then Portuguese did not have enough economic and military resources to compete with other European powers. Second point, they faced resistance from native forces. They faced resistance from native forces. I think you hear the name Kunyali Marakyar. Kunyali Marakyar was the admirals of Zamorin's naval force. Kunyali Marakyar were the admirals of Zamorin's naval force. Led the resistance against the Portuguese in the Malabar region. Our topic, that is the Dutch. The Dutch were another European force who reached India following the Portuguese. Following Portuguese, the Dutch people reached in our country. Then which were the major trade centers of Dutch? No doubt, our Kochi and Kollam were the major trade centers of the Dutch. Kochi and Kollam were the major trade centers. Then you know that the Portuguese known as Parangis, but at the same time the Dutch were known as Lanthans. Then the Dutch were known as Lanthans. The Dutch governor Van Reed, a new name, the Dutch governor Van Reed, who initiated the combination of Hortus Malabaricus, a book on the medicinal plants of Kerala. He compiled that book with the help of Itti Achyuthan Vaidyan. Then listen carefully, the major contribution of Dutch to our country, that is Hortus Malabaricus. Dutch fought with Martanda Varma, the king of Travancore, following the dispute over trade. Then related with the trade, some problem arose between the Travancore king Martanda Varma and the Dutch. Then they together a war. What happened? The Dutch were defeated in the Battle of Kolachel in 1741. Maybe the after effect, the Dutch lost their ground in India with this war. That means they lost their power in our country. Next important topic, that is the advent of English. That means the arrival of English. The English East India Company was formed in England in 1600. 1600, English East India Company was formed in Britain. For what purpose? For trade with the countries like India and China. Actually, that is a trading company. Then, when they reach our country, which are their major trade centers? First trade center was Surat in Gujarat. Surat in Gujarat was the first trade center of English East India Company in India. Then next trading centers are Bombay. Then Bombay means now that place known as Mumbai. Next Calcutta means Kolkata. Then Madras, that means Chennai. Then Surat in Gujarat. Then Mumbai, that means Bombay. Then Calcutta and Madras are the major trade centers of English in our country. Next our topic, that is French trade relation. French East India Company established in 1664 and the French reached India for the purpose of trade, same purpose. Then which were their major trade centers? First trade center, that is Pondicherry. Pondicherry, now known as Puducherry. Then Mahi and Karaikal were the major trade centers of French in our country. Then their trade headquarters was Pondicherry. Pondicherry was their headquarters. One map is there in your textbook. Then your responsibility to prepare a list of different European trade centers based on this map. Can you identify any common feature of these trade centers? Then from this map, you realize that Cochin, Kollam, Mahi situated in our Kerala. Pondicherry, Karaikal, Madras, Tamil Nadu. Then Kolkata, West Bengal. Bombay, Maharashtra. Surat in Gujarat. Daman and Diu, both places are union territories. Then Goa, place that is Goa. Then common feature, that is these all trade centers are situated in seashore. For what purpose they constructed their trading centers on the banks of that sea? Reason behind that, trade purpose. Earlier that is only water transportation. That's why they selected these trade centers. Dear students, if you like my class, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching my class.